Hello, my name is Brian Bauer, a sergeant with the Phoenix Police Department's Public Affairs Bureau. The information, audio, and videos you are about to see are intended to provide details as we currently understand them of an in-custody death that occurred on February 11th, 2023. The following video and audio clips were collected from various sources, including 911 calls and body-worn cameras worn by officers. This video may contain strong language as well as graphic images, which could be disturbing to some people. Viewer discretion is advised. This incident occurred in the area of 44th Street and McDowell Road when Phoenix police received a 911 call of a man acting erratic and breaking property inside of an inpatient facility. Here is a portion of the initial 911 call made by employees of the facility at 5:38 p.m.
Phoenix 911, what's the location of your emergency?
Yes, sir. We have a crisis situation. We're at we have a client that is just out of control. Violent.
Oh, what's he doing?
He's throwing, hitting stuff. He's breaking everything.
Okay, what's the address?
He's coming down off drugs, so he's a little bit delusional.
The next audio clip captures the call being dispatched to officers. 722 India is the call sign of the two-man patrol unit responding to the call.
722 India, is there a traffic over here?
722 India 10-4. The subject that's breaking property, white male, 40 years of age, medium build, gray shirt, blue sweatpants, white shoes. He also broke a window in the building. Apparently he's coming down from 237 David. His name is...
Body-worn cameras are used by all officers assigned to patrol and several specialty units. Per policy, they are worn at mid-torso level and capture the view of line of sight from that perspective. It's important to note that the camera lens is fixed and does not capture everything seen or experienced by officers. When activated, both audio and video turn on. The body-worn camera has a buffer of video without audio for 30 seconds prior to activation. This feature is designed to capture incidents that happen suddenly where an officer doesn't immediately activate the camera. When the first two officers arrived, they saw the man described by the caller sitting behind a trash can near the side of a building and using the trash can lid to hit himself in the head. The following body-worn camera video is from one of the first officers to arrive.
Do you want us to help you?
Yeah, listen, you look like you're stuck.
You want us to take that?
Yeah, but let me get that. It looks heavy. Let me get that for you.
No, I got it, man.
Huh?
What the fuck is this shoe, man, nigga?
Yeah.
Do you want
to fuck a shoe.
Hey, relax, relax.
I don't want to die.
No, you're not. You're okay. Let go. Let go.
I don't want to die.
Hey.
It's heavy. Please. You gotta be careful,
please,
Brian.
Please, dude. I'm trying to act good. That's it.
Yeah,
I'm from the dope, but it's hungry.
You want me to get the picture?
Yeah, let's not pull it away. Hey, Brian, can we, I
want
to help you.
Yeah. Turn it back on or what?
Huh? He's...
Yeah, that's the thing. I don't want to...
Yeah, we can back up.
Hey, Brian.
Please, God. No.
Can we help you? You're okay, Brian. You're okay, man.
You want
to go to the doctor?
Can I help you?
Please, God.
What's up? What are you trying to do, Brian?
Can I help you? Let me help you. Brian, can I bring you somewhere to get some help? I want to get you out of here. Can I get you out of here? Brian? Can I get you out of here, Brian? Yes or no? Do you want to get out of here? Huh?
You can probably back it up, ask for more, maybe two more. Do you want to try?
Oh, let's just try to talk for a second.
I don't think it's getting anywhere.
Okay. Yeah, we can back up.
Officers backed away to wait for more resources while they continued to talk with the man. As more officers arrived, they formulated a plan to recontact and detain the man, who is still in the same location. Once the man was detained, he began having a medical emergency and the fire department was called. Here is the body-worn camera video from one of the officers as they re-engage with the man.
Turn over on your belly, portion. Can you turn over?
Relax. Relax.
Left one's good.
Bros.
Oh,
You want a second?
Nah. Ready?
There, got it.
Here we go.
I got a rip in my pocket. Okay. Grab this foot for me. I'm going to get
that. Yeah. He's in cool.
All right. Got him. I got a rip.
No, you're not needed. We can clear.
Relax, man. I'm going to get you some help.
And I cleared it whenever you. Yeah.
Bring it
up. Let me bring the cart.
You're gonna want a spit mask. What's that? This is gonna go everywhere.
All right. I can go grab. Yeah, I can grab that and pull the cart.
Okay.
You good?
Yeah.
Go on.
You all right? That's real fire.
Good.
Yeah. 7-20. Can you roll fire, please?
Hey, you all right, man?
Here is the body-worn camera from the perspective of another officer as they handcuffed the man.
Relax.
This one's good. You want a second?
I got it. Here we go.
I got it. Okay.
Put it out?
Yeah.
You guys want fire, or you just gotta take them straight to the PC? Also, if you have a spit mask.
Yeah, sure.
Because he's gonna, you're gonna want a spit mask because he's bleeding, so this is gonna go everywhere.
Okay. Right. I can go grab, yeah, I can grab that and pull the car.
Okay.
You good?
Yeah.
Cool. I got one.
You alright? That's real fire.
Yeah, it's just cute, kid.
Yeah.
Throw him on the side, just go fire.
Hey, you all right, man?
Officers called the fire department. They arrived to treat the man and take him to the hospital. While in the back of the ambulance, the man became critical, at which time his restraints were removed and life-saving measures were taken by paramedics. The man did not survive and was pronounced deceased at the hospital. A total of 5 officers were involved in this incident, all of which are assigned to the Mountain View precinct and have approximately 3 to 6 years of service with the department. This incident is a subject of a criminal investigation, which will be reviewed by the Maricopa County Attorney's Office. It is also the subject of an administrative investigation. Conclusions about whether the actions of the officers are consistent with department policy and the law will not be made until all facts are known and the investigation is complete.
This video was intended to inform and educate the public about a critical incident in our community. You can learn about the Phoenix Police Department's transparency policy on our website.